is back in Los Angeles as we welcome you inside the StubHub Center in Carson, California. The scene a moment ago, unlike any other in the NFL for a lot of years. The crowd here in Carson might be half the size of a normal NFL stadium, but they are twice as loud as their Chargers get set to face off with the Kansas City Chiefs. Now the rookie from Toledo, this is Kareem Hunt. Trying to run inside, but nothing there. No gain on the play. It'll be second down. Well, a well-executed blitz, no doubt. Great job by the linebacker. Maybe the quarterback, if he could have seen that, could have audibled there.
Yeah, he needed to be in a different play because that one just meshed perfectly for the defense. All the gaps were filled except for the one the offense really wanted to run through, and that was filled by a big man wanting to make a tackle.
And he made a great tackle. Throwing is Smith. Harris has it over the middle. And this one will go to the 28-yard line. The reception good for 7. It's third down.
The completion was given up, but that's why you play zone defense, so that you can have people around the ball when it's caught and you don't give up much run after the catch.
An early test. 2 plays in. This is 3rd and 2. Smith going to give this one to Hunt. He's got the first down and more, past the 40. And he's got the first down yardage before he's brought down at the 42. That goes for a Chiefs first down, 14 yards. It was just 3rd down and short, but he bit off a little extra.
I would say way more than he could chew, but he chewed up all that yardage in a big way. And that, to me, that was a combination of offensive line, stacked defense, and they handled it, okay? They got the leverage, they got the blocking angles, and opened up a nice crease. And once you get past that first wave, there's room to roam.
Yeah, that's just a 3rd play from scrimmage. They wanted to avoid that 3 and out. They did. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a 2nd and 3.
Well, that run right there was an offensive line coach's dream, wasn't it? Guys picked up all of their assignments, created a nice gap for the running back to get through, pick up 7 yards. Yeah, he's probably chortling on the headset right now saying, "We got it going, boys. Let's keep it going."
On 2nd down, here's Smith, looking middle, and it's incomplete. His favorite target, Travis Kelce, the intended receiver, and it's 3rd and short. Well, too much oomph, too much mustard there on that pass.
They really turned it loose, didn't they? Really cut loose with that one, sharp, strong. Didn't lead to a completion, though. Made it very difficult.
Smith on 3rd down. Able to find Harris, complete. And he's taken down at the 43, but not before picking up the first. 8 yards on the pickup there, and it moves the sticks.
I don't believe that this opening drive is surprising to either one of us after the time we spent with the coaching staff and players prior to the game. What about you?
Absolutely. Not only that, but that big article in this paper this morning about their philosophy on starting games like you're shot out of a cannon, and that's what they've done. Very methodical here on this first drive.
Yeah, so many teams talk about that fast start. We're actually seeing it happen right here in front of us.
But now the kicker. Can they cap it off by putting the ball in the end zone?
That's a good play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. Held them to a gain of 2. And that changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. 2nd and 8. Now he's got to probably think about going to the air instead of maybe staying with the ground game.
They'll run it now. This is Charkhandrick West. They'll fight forward for a couple down inside the 40.
Partner, we know today's NFL is really built around the guy throwing the football. But these short runs, they still pay dividends because they can take their toll on a defense and they can add up as the game goes along. You control the clock, you control the ball, and that way you often control the game.
So they need 6 yards here on 3rd down. They're 2 for 2 on 3rd down tries so far on this drive. Now a play fake, and it's Smith. And he gets it down a yard or 2 shy of the 30 before he's out of bounds. A Kansas City 1st down, Smith finding Hill that time. Nice job keeping that opening drive alive, and they're in plus territory, that part of the field where you really want to convert on 3rd down. They did.
Big time pickup for them, and now I think the aggressive play callers think to themselves, this part of the field, I take my shot at the end zone, because the closer you get to the end zone, the field gets condensed. Makes it a lot tougher to run those routes. You still got a chance to actually run past people right now. Take your shot at the end zone early in the down and distance count.
Now the offense lining up first and 10. They'll run it now out of the gun. He winds up getting only a couple there, down to the 29. And the offense readies for play number 10 of this series. To throw on second down is Smith. Throw left side, taken in by Hill. And he is going to be knocked flat on his back. Oh, a big hit at the 21-yard line. Little nugget on that receiver, Tyreek Hill. He had the streak of five straight games with 60-plus yard touchdowns snapped in week two. That was an NFL record.
He's got six of those overall. As you mentioned, five in a row. That got snapped against Philadelphia. Still had four catches for 43 yards. Still ran the ball from the running back position. He affects the game because defensive coordinators have to know where he's going to line up on every snap. And that can alter what they do on defense and open up things for some of his offensive mates.
It's a four-yard pickup, and that'll make this a second down. He's already proven to be a factor in the running game on this drive. Now he gets involved in the passing game.
I think what we're seeing here is the modern version of workhorse in the NFL, being able to run it and catch it with equal proficiency.
Here's Smith now on second down. This will be caught just inside the 10. And brought down, but not before they get it inside the 10 to the 7. A Kansas City first, Smith fighting his fellow Pro Bowler, Kelsey. Kelsey, Charles, coming off a great game, as you saw last week, over 100 yards and a touchdown.
I just love the way that he gets utilized in head coach Andy Reid's offense. He's a tight end as listed, but they use him for wide receiver plays. They use him as a wildcat quarterback at times. They'll run him down the line of scrimmage and throw a shovel pass to him, so essentially he becomes a running back. And he affects the game as well. You got to know where Travis Kelce is on every snap before you set up your defense. And he moves around a lot to create mismatches. And the game that he played against Philadelphia was vintage Travis Kelce. Caught it, ran it, played with joy and enthusiasm.
Now some movement before the snap. And we'll hear from our referee for the first time this afternoon. Just play after play after play on this long drive for the offense. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll get four there, down to about the 12-yard line.
Well, that call makes sense because they've been throwing it well on this drive, and once again they show passing formation, showing the shotgun. Then they ran out of it. That's a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short gain.
Back now with Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gauden. As the Chiefs in possession of the football as we begin the second quarter. And they'll come up looking to keep this drive moving. Now Smith on third and goal. That's going to be caught at the 10-yard line. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. A 4-yard pickup, not enough. Fourth down.
They didn't get the first down, but I have to say I do like the call. I like what they were trying to do. Try and hit your receiver on the run and see if he can pick it up. Keep it on his feet, get a little rack yardage.
Yeah, but a nice job defensively to get to him and keep him short of the first. And Santos able to put this one up and through. It's good. And the Chiefs are out to a 3-0 lead. And we were scoreless up until this point in the second quarter. Now we finally have a little action.
Let's see where this action takes us. First quarter, no points at all. Now we've got our first score of the game. Well, does that signal that we're going to get more as we go along, or will it revert back to what we saw in the beginning of the game?
After the made field goal, Santos back out there to kick it away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll elect not to return this one, so they'll bring it out to the 25 on the touchback.
Charles, let's pivot for a second here. Got a moment. Toughest division so far certainly seems to be the AFC West, right? I mean, you have three undefeated teams.
And we thought that going into the season. If you rank the toughest division in football based on last year's records and who they would play, the AFC West shows up as number one. And so far, they're handling it pretty well. Kansas City's 2-0 and beat New England on the road on opening night. Oakland Raiders went to Tennessee, a trendy pick in the AFC South to win the division. Beat them on opening day. They're 2-0. And the Denver Broncos, behind Trevor Siemian and that great defense, also off to a 2-0 start.
Offense looking to avoid a third and long. It's second and 10. From the shotgun, it's Rivers. And this is caught. First catch for Keenan Allen. And he's able to get out to the 32, brought down there. The reception good for seven. It's third down. And that's one of his advantages of a passer, is it not? With his height, setting back there in the pocket, firing it over the middle, he can really see everything clearly.
It is, and I know that other quarterbacks get it done different ways, all right? You don't have to be his height to make a great play, but what he does is he takes away having to make those slide steps in the pocket to find angles to throw the ball through. He just throws right over the top of it because he can see everything, and sometimes that saves time and gets the ball to a receiver quicker. I'm not sure we could spot any tendency here on this third down. They could have run it or passed it. Either one was available. They chose to try and get it through the air, but they run successful.
On now, Kazer, the punter, sending it away. 51 yards on the punt there. And the Chiefs are going to take over with a long field ahead and a first and 10. Now the Chiefs offense, they get ready to head on the field. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But they also have to remember, they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easily done.
He's going to dump this off to his running back, Hunt. That one good for 12 yards into Kansas City first. With a give to Hunt across the 30 to the 31-yard line. A gain of 3, second down.
Not much happening there on first down.
I thought there might have been a hole for a split second.
Yeah, but it dried up pretty quickly, didn't it? Closed fast.
Stay on the ground again. It's Hunt, and he'll scratch out only about a yard up to the 32.
Well, now they're in a spot that every team tells us when we have our production meetings they don't want to be in, third and long, and that's because those back-to-back running plays just didn't accomplish a whole lot.
The Chiefs on third down. They've been good, 3 for 4 thus far. This will be third and 6. Throwing on third down, Smith.
And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down.
That's a first down if he holds on, but you saw the contact, able to jar it free from him and force a fourth down.
Great play defensively there, as you said, just to knock it free, because if he had caught that, pass the sticks, first down. On fourth down, on is Dustin Colquitt to kick this away. Travis Benjamin deep for the Chargers. That'll be a 48-yard punt, 1 yard on the return. And it'll be Charger football here as they take over. And now out on the field, here comes Los Angeles. And they'll certainly be trying to do better than that first drive where they went three and out.
And sometimes the first drive is just simply to settle nerves. You know what it's like at the start of a game with the emotion. Guys a little bit jumpy.
But you do.
Oh, you understand the same way. It's just like us calling one, right? Making sure we ease into the game, let it come to us.
Well, you went 3-and-out.
And now they have that opportunity.
No, you didn't go 3-and-out. I went 3-and-out on that first drive. I'll try to do better here. The Chargers getting set to go. And the first drive, 3-and-out. Second possession. See if they can get a little momentum.
And oftentimes that first drive is just a feeling out process. You have some plays that you've got called and you want to see how defense reacts. It may not go terrific on the first one. Now they're ready to go. They've kind of got a look at them, got a sense. Let's see if they open things up a little bit.
See if they open things up. Let's see what the defense does here, too, after a good stop. They run. It's Oliver. And not much there. Maybe a yard up to the 24.
Felt me get a little jangly up there before that last play call. And then once it happened, I was like, oh, because it feels like almost a missed golden opportunity to take a shot in that position.
You think first and five, maybe you go for a little more than a short run?
Almost a free down.
They go again with Oliver. And he's going to be run over, hit hard, as he'll be marked down right around the 26. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a third and three.
But when you go from second and four to third and three, that just tells you who won that battle on the last play, huh?
Yeah, first round went to the offense, second round the defense. Third and short yardage, Rivers. And he'll just toss it away. So he throws it away, and that brings up fourth down. Here's Drew Kayser now, on for his second punt. He'd take a repeat of his first. It'll be a 51-yard punt that time. And it's Chiefs football, first and 10. And now here comes Kansas City. They're out in front. Last time they had to punt it away. We'll see if they can add to their lead now.
They don't want to go out and punt it away again. This team now wants to get a cushion, put people away. They want to run their offense and have it end up in the end zone.
Now contact up front as penalty markers come in. Who is this against? And he got a little aggressive too early.
And he did, wanting that quick takeoff as the ball was snapped. But I think sometimes those big guys on offense, they're pretty cagey too, right? They make those little sudden moves or those little subtle moves that get you to jump.
Here's Hunt. And some room to maneuver. And he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line. They get 9 out of that one, and as a result, the drive continues.
Now, that's the way to do it. Hand it to someone with vision and good footwork and handle it a little bit of power, and you find a way to pick up first downs.
They don't need to run another play here before the 2-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway. They run again with Hunt. And he'll get this up past the 45 to the 47. It's a gain of 8, and it's going to take us to the 2-minute warning. And some options here for the offense on 2nd and 2. From the gun, here's Smith. He'll leave it for Hunt, complete. And he'll be brought down at the 48-yard line. They get 5 out of that one, and it moves the chains. Throw, it's Smith to the right side, it's Kelce, and he'll get it down to the 47 here, just a yard on the catch there. It'll be 2nd and 9. I know when you got a top tight end like this, you want to get him involved, but when you do, you're hoping for more than that.
You certainly are. You've got to try and get him some space where he can make a play downfield, or at least an opportunity for some rack yardage, right, that run after catch.
Here's Smith, looking to throw on 2nd down. Oh, the rookie nearly had the pick. Probably should have had it. 3rd down now.
Pretty nice coverage there, but a missed opportunity for an interception. Let's face it, a lot of these defenders, they've got it all. Speed, athleticism, hands, a little bit questionable.
The Chiefs on 3rd down. They've converted 3 out of 5 thus far. This is 3rd and 9. Again, Smith, and he'll go down shy of the 40 at the 41. The completion good for only 6, and that'll bring up 4th.
He wasn't the primary target, but I think it was almost like a check down situation, wasn't it?
Yeah, hoping he can break some tackles, a big tight end, but he couldn't do it.
Yeah, get it to that big frame and hope he could scatter some bodies, unable to get it done.
Here we go on 4th, Smith. And that will be incomplete with a clock down now to 13 seconds. Andy Reid went for it, but it won't pan out. And the Charger defense stands tall, and they get the football back. Even though they didn't get it, probably the right call. Too long for a field goal and just not a whole lot to gain from a punt there.
Yeah, you wouldn't have really netted very much yardage if you punt the ball, right? And the thing about a field goal, and you know this from so much experience, the longer the field goal, the lower it comes out off the kick, right? Which means it's got a better chance of being blocked. So you're taking a chance either way. I like the fact they went for it.
Now a timeout taken. Perhaps a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout if they hurry. We'll see. The Charger offense making their way back out there. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play. But we do know there's some risk takers out there that may want to take one more shot before the clock runs out.
Second down now after the pass completion. From the gun, Rivers. And that will be incomplete. 4 ticks left here on the clock. Keenan Allen, the intended target, and it's 3rd and 4.
I tell you, Brandon, this defense is playing with some confidence. Haven't allowed a point yet. Flying to the football. I'm telling you, it's almost 11 to the ball on every snap. Another nice job there to force an incompletion.
And you see the clock almost empty, so this is likely the last play in the 2nd quarter. Final play of the half, Rivers. Going deep here for Allen. And unable to connect on the long pass. It falls down incomplete. So we've reached halftime with the visiting Chiefs on top. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number 3. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And in hindsight, probably should have stayed where he was, as he'll only get back to the 16-yard line. Out comes the Chargers as they'll go on offense now to start this 3rd quarter. They're down here, but very much in this game. What's the tonality of a coach's talk when a game is within striking distance like this at intermission?
Typically, what they're doing is emphasizing the things that went well in the first half and wanting more of that. Sure, you've got to go over some of the errors and clean up some things because there's a reason you're down. But overall, I think they want to stay positive, stay up with this team. We're just starting the second half, and we've got the football. Let's go ahead and punch it in, and then we'll take it from there.
See how that recipe works. Call it a gain of four on first, and that'll make it second down. And after the play on the ground, that brings up second down here. Working out of the gun, Rivers. Throw right side, complete to Williams. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. That one good for 13 and a Charger first. Offense comes to the line now, first and 10. Now Rivers going to give it off to Gordon. And he'll lose yardage. Brought down at the 32. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
And that's another stop for the defense, something we've seen all game long. They've been on fire today. No matter what's called by the offense, they've had an answer for it.
And the offense behind the chains here, a touch on second and 11. From the gun, Rivers. Caught left side, Williams. And he'll be out of bounds after getting this one across the 40. They'll get nine there as that sets him up better for third down.
Well, it appears that they read man defense and went to the out route. And what you have to do on that one is the receiver's got to make sure he works the defender towards the middle of the field to give himself space to cut to the outside and have that ball delivered with good timing. And they got it done.
Play fake to Gordon. Now Rivers finds his target. It's Gates. And he's going to get this down to the 35-yard line. A pickup of 24 on the third down conversion.
Do you get the sense, Brandon, that people are trying to retire Antonio Gates? They keep thinking this is almost the end of the line. And then he keeps making catches like the one we just saw there.
He's the old reliable, you're right, just one of nine players in the NFL with 100 or more touchdowns. On first and 10, Rivers. It's caught on the right side, Williams. And all the way in for a Charger touchdown. Tyrell Williams, 35 yards. And the Chargers are able to strike for six.
I know these wide receivers are about flash and dash and high-flying plays, but a good number of them play running back at some point in their career, and that's how they finish off a lot of their big plays, run after the catch.
And this, oh, they get to the football. It's blocked, but he doesn't get far. They're able to stop him, and after all that, the extra point attempt unsuccessful.
Oftentimes when you give up a touchdown, it's really a deflation for your entire unit. And the special teams group, when they run out there, they still feel it. And maybe they don't go after it so much. Instead, they gave great effort there. Blocked the extra point and really gave them a lift after giving up the score.
Yeah, gave up the touchdown, lost the lead, but a nice job to get in there and block it. Start with Hunt on the ground, and not a whole lot doing there as he'll get it up to about the 28-yard line. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and nine.
This is what happens sometimes when you abandon the running game. It's hard to get back to it because once guys get out of that mentality of firing out and hitting people, hard to get them started again occasionally.
They'll run again with Hunt. And they'll bring him down after just a short pickup. Only a yard on the pickup, and now they've got a third down and eight.
Back-to-back runs, I'd say that encompassed maximum effort for minimal gain.
Minimal yardage, and now they're going to need something more than minimal on this play coming up. The Chiefs on third down. They've hit it 50%, 3 of 6 to this point. This is 3rd and 8. A shotgun snap for Smith. And the third down pass falls incomplete. Fair to say, hasn't been his best game throwing the football, but also not getting a lot of help out there either.
Yeah, you nailed it pretty well, you know. He's got to throw it better, got to get more help. Obviously, one that should have been caught. They've got to find a way to bring those two elements together so they can make some progress in this one.
Colquitt on the kick as he sends it away. Now Benjamin. That'll be put in the books as a 53-yard punt. And that will come the offense as they take over. And now out on the field, here comes Los Angeles. On first down, and he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. 7 yards the pickup on the pitch and catch.
I do have to admit, I like it when it all comes together, when the top part, catching the football, right, whether you're catching it with your hands or cradling it, comes together with the legs, in this case the feet, doing a little toe tap to stay in bounds and complete the catch.
And a great job by our crew on the camera shot. Love when you see the grass or on the field turf, those rubber pellets flying up. Great catch. And the offense still has a couple plays to go to pick up the first on 2nd down and 3. And now whistles and a flag, and I think we got a jump here. So they jumped on the left side of that line.
And you know, when you're at the end spot, you are like in the starting blocks, waiting for the pistol to fire and go, and he jumped a little bit too early.
The penalty. Here's Gordon. Room to run past midfield. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. It'll be a pickup of 16 and a Charger first.
Absolutely love the run right there. This guy's known for his quickness, but also for his speed. He's able to get to the second level almost before you blink if you give him any type of blocking. Always talk about slot receivers, and they're usually known as quicker than fast. In this case, we've got a guy who's quick and fast, and he used it to great advantage.
This is Gordon as they go to him again. And he'll be out of bounds, able to take it down to the 40. Call it a gain of 13 yards on the play. And it'll be a 2nd down.
Really tough drive, but that run helped salvage something there, because now there's something positive that came out of it. They got to see good blocking, good push by the offensive line, wide receivers trying to get involved, a good run by the back. And now maybe it'll be a catalyst for them to look at going forward, watching it on tape. Maybe they can keep incorporating that type of a run into their offense.
Allen has it left side, and he gets it down to the 32. A Charger first down. Rivers hooking up with Allen. And defensively, they were in zone coverage there. Do you have to be a little careful? You're losing playing against a good quarterback like he is to not play too much zone?
Yeah, you have to be careful about how much time you're giving up. I think it's a good point you just brought up. So maybe if you still want to play zone, you go to a zone blitz game. And you can drop anyone out of your defensive front, defensive end, defensive tackle. It doesn't matter. You just exchange someone to bring more pressure towards the quarterback and still try and cover downfield.
14 yards is the pickup there and a Charger first down.
Now that was pretty. They executed that curl route versus zone coverage, and that changes things a little bit because against man, it's often a tight curl, tight, sharply run route. Against zone, you're just looking for that open spot, that dead area, so you may curl it a little bit wider just to get to that place.
And usually a tight window, he fired a bullet in there for the completion. And this time the yards won't come so easy as they'll in fact tackle him behind the line. It'll be a loss of a yard, and that'll bring up a second and 11. Taking this inside the 10 to the 7. It's a nice pickup of 12 yards, and it gives him a first and goal.
The running game's played a huge part in getting him down to this point on the field. I say stay with it. Keep pounding the football. Keep driving. Keep grinding.
Yeah, even down in the red zone, keep going for it.
No doubt about it. Dance with what brung you.
First down and goal to go from the 7. On the run, it's Oliver. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. They'll say no gain on the play, and it'll be second and goal. And in this situation with the lead fourth quarter, they're liking keeping the ball on the ground, I'm sure.
That's just smart football, but you know the defense has to know it as well. They've got to stop them here. So now we're going to see that loading the box in a big way. 6, 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take, puts a little bit more pressure on your big offensive line.
And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down. Something to think about with these Chargers. They had 4 losses a season ago when leading with 3 minutes or less.
So you think that their fans right now, they're hopeful, but not necessarily expecting it to go their way.
Yeah, not counting their chickens just yet. Third and goal for Rivers. He dropped it. Couldn't hang on in the end zone. So no 6 points, incomplete.
They may be snapping the ball near the goal line, but all you're thinking defensively, keep them out of the end zone. Force the incompletion, force them into going for 3 and not giving up 6.
So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. From the right hash here, should be an easy one. And his kick is good. And the lead will increase to 6 now. It's 9-3. So they get the 3 here, but you wonder whether that's going to be enough.
Yeah, I mean, you've now made it so they need a touchdown rather than a field goal to catch them. But you're right. If they'd gotten 6 out of that drive, this would be a much different game.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. This is fielded at the goal line. And he'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. So now here are the Chiefs as their offense makes their way back out onto the field. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
On first down, it's Smith. That's out to Hill, right side complete. And he'll be brought down right at the 30 here. So that flag will cost him 15.
And it doesn't matter anymore how you get the face mask. Any part of it, that's going to be 15 yards.
first and 10. Smith. Over the middle here to Wilson. And he's going to get this down to the 35-yard line. A good pick up there of 20 yards. And there they went crossing route against the zone defense. What do you think of that?
Takes real coordination between the passer and the receiver, because you've got to read those zones and where the open spots are and be on the same page with the guy throwing the football. Because sometimes you're throwing it in front of the zone, sometimes you're throwing it between the zones, sometimes the receiver's going to just kind of find a spot and what we call sit down and present himself to the quarterback and throw it there. It's a tough read, but when they're in sync, it's really effective.
And they still need 8 yards for the first here on second down. Out of the gun, Smith. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Harris. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. The Chiefs have got the passing game rolling a bit, and another first down.
When this offense can get their tight ends involved, they can move the football. Here, a nice route, able to look it in, and picks up the first down.
On first down, Smith. Oh, no, he lost the football. But it looks like the Chiefs are going to get it back.
On plays like this where the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back. Because this is the quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or have moved away from it. In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball.
Now whistles and a flag down. Looked like one of the Chief linemen might have moved. Second down, here's Smith. And it's caught over the middle, Wilson. And he'll go down at the 28. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down.
One of the selling points at the in route is it gives the quarterback a really nice sight line to his receiver, and almost on a direct shot, able to throw the ball into the middle of the field and have a great chance of success, as they did on that play.
Possibly a turning point. Big play coming. This is third and long. Smith, from the gun, he'll throw. He's got the hookup with Conley. And he'll be out of bounds as he gets this down to about the 21 or 22. Umpire threw the flag, usually always indicates holding, and that's what we've got.
And you know, depending on their positioning, where you are on the field, the umpires get different responsibilities, but always, always making sure no one's holding.
The Chiefs on third down, 3 for 7 so far in this game. This will be third and forever. Off of play action, here's Smith. So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. This will be from 56 yards out. And this kick is not going to be close. It's well short, well right to boot. And this score will stay right where it is.
Everything looked good. Good snap, good hold. Sometimes, though, the ball just doesn't want to go where you want it. And this one winds up no good.
Three down.
He'll start on the ground. This is Gordon on first down. And they went the wrong way there, losing yardage back at the 43-yard line. Defensively, no doubt they need a quick stop. Offensively here, maybe do you put it in the air on second down, or do you go ahead and keep it on the ground, keep that clock moving?
A lot of people would ask that question, partner, because sometimes throwing the ball might actually be the path of least resistance. But in this case, it's a matter of trust. How much do you trust your quarterback? Because you throw the ball and it goes awry, you really don't look smart as a coach.
Yeah, and then you stop that clock. And he's brought down. 18 big yards on that one, and a Charger first. Defensively, they're okay with that. Short little route, tackle him inbounds. Okay.
All right, cliche alert. It's time for someone to make a play because they've got to have something bigger downfield. They can't just take what they give them. They've got to force it and make something big happen for them.
Fresh set of downs here. Rivers going to turn and give this one to his running back, Gordon. And he'll lose yardage here, back at the 41. And now right out of the two-minute break, we'll get a timeout used defensively with a minute 56 to go. Keep it on the ground. Again, Gordon. So he got free of one tackle, but couldn't do a whole lot else. Whistles now and a timeout. So defensively, they burn it here with 1:51 left. The Chargers on third down, just 1 for 5 to this point. This is 3rd and 8. Rivers to throw. Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete. And this play will be blown up. He'll lose yardage back at the 38. He lost 2, and it brings up 4th.
I love the intelligence the defense just showed there. Read their keys, saw the screen developing, ran to it and smothered it. What a third down stop by them.
And it's off the left upright. Oh my goodness, heartache. It's no good. And this score will stay right where it is. So distance not the issue there. He had plenty of leg to get it there. It's that darn upright getting in the way.
Always gets in the way of a good time, doesn't it? Because he hit it square, too. Sometimes you can bank one in if you get it on the end of the football. No such luck there for him.
They'll look to throw. Incomplete, but a penalty flag is down in the backfield. Let's get the call. That hold coming from the left side of the line.
Hands got caught in the cookie jar on that one, and the flag came out. Penalty against them.
Complete. He was trying to get it to Tyreek Hill that time. And it's 2nd down. Second down following the incompletion.
to throw. And that is incomplete.
So many offenses want to include their running backs into their passing offense and be able to swing the ball out and check it down to them. But sometimes those guys are just not as comfortable catching the ball as they are running it.
The Chiefs on third down. They've converted 3 times and 8 chances. This will be 3rd and a mile.
He'll look to throw. He's going to let it fly. And he knocks the ball away, and it falls incomplete.
So another big shot dodged there defensively. Now they're just one more incompletion away from salting away this victory. And I know this feeling. They're almost giddy, but they have to stay focused and locked in. They can make one big mistake and throw it all away.
So down 6, and they know they need this one on 4th down. He's back to throw. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And that'll be just about all she wrote for this one. Victory formation, time for the Chargers. They take a knee. A kneel down here from Rivers, and that should be it. Well, Charles, the old saying, the old cliche, if you will, points at a premium. That certainly applied here, didn't it?
And that almost felt like opened up a time capsule, didn't it? Old school football, low scoring, close game. What a way to finish it up.
You loved it, didn't you? You loved the defenses.
I certainly did. Brought back the images of the game of old.
That'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our hardworking crew, I'm Brandon Gaudin. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, find us on Twitter at EA Madden NFL.